Hello and welcome to this series of short videos that we will talk about design and diversity. My name is Vasiliki and my background is in human-computer interaction. I feel personally engaged with the subject of diversity as I experience dyslexia and ADHD. This series consists of four videos, the current one, that will describe very briefly the field of human-computer interaction. The second one, which will discuss a bit about technologies and different designs that support a variety or a diversity of bodies and minds. The third video is about the notion or the word normal and what that means. And the final video introduces briefly some tools that we can use in our designs to increase our empathy towards the users. Introduction to human-computer interaction. From some people, human-computer interaction is the scientific field of interaction design. Some others say that interaction design is bigger than human-computer interaction. So in this series, we will perceive human-computer interaction as the scientific field of interaction design. Human-computer interaction is a relatively new field, as it has been created, it has been evolved together with commercialization of the personal computers in the 80s. And the computers went into the market, and it wasn't only scientists and computer engineers that they were using computers, so they had to design them in a way that anyone can use them. So the human-computer interaction is strongly connected, the field is strongly connected with human factors, and it is a multidisciplinary field. So you can see people with background in computer engineering, computer science, art, product design, film industry, social sciences. So it's a mix of different disciplines. If you want to learn more about the field of human-computer interaction, as well as about the design processes that we will shortly start talking about, you can invest on the Interaction Design Beyond Human-Computer Interaction book. You can find some links about this book and free resources of the book in the description of the video. And I have created videos that are based on the first 11 chapters of this book. You can find the link below. The Design Council in UK described the design process as a double diamond, which consists of four phases. The first part, the first diamond, consists of the phase discover. So you try to understand the environment, the user, their needs, their wishes, what are problematic areas, and so on. The next phase of the first diamond is the phase define. So in that phase, you identify problematic cases or issues that they have appeared while you were observing the users and understand their environment. And finally, you need to pick one specific problem and describe it in the design brief in order to move on to the second diamond, which consists of the phase develop, which is the phase that you can start prototyping some solutions, evaluate them with users, and do the same process again until you reach to the next stage, which is deliver, and you deliver the final product. Of course, this is not a linear process. You can move between the different phases. And this is just an illustration, a simplified version of design. And in my opinion, is a really nice guide for people who start designing to have in order to make it make design more structured than it is. How the design feels is exactly like this image. In the beginning, you feel that you have a lot of options, it's a chaotic situation, you have a lot of information, you get to know the users, you see different issues, and it's you feel that it's hard to specify what are the problematic areas or what the user needs. But as the time passes and you work into the design, the process becomes clearer. And for understanding the philosophy behind the design, I will suggest a book, The Design Way, of Eric Stolterman and Nelson. You will find the link in the description of this video. One important thing to think about our designs is that we affect people's life. Whatever we design, either it is in the physical world or in the digital world, we affect people's accessibility. And you can see that with a simple example of the mouse. When we started designing the mouse, it was mainly for right-handed people, people who use the right hand, but there are many people who use their left hand. So the design had to change so it could accommodate people who use their left hand.